Hey, good afternoon, everybody. It's KB5MIQ Big Boy. Got a little subject we want to talk about today. First, I want to thank everybody who subscribed to the channel. I hit 136 subscribers. I'm not up with the big boys yet, but we're trying, and we enjoy doing this to help promote the hobby. And we got WD5HKV and W5DLX helping me with ideas here, and we really enjoy doing this for y'all, and hopefully we can keep moving and keep the channel growing. I apologize for my audio-visual techniques aren't better. I'm working on it. I finally figured out how to put a thumbnail on here so y'all don't have to see pictures of me picking my nose. I don't know how YouTube picked that out. But anyway, we got a subject we want to talk about today, and where a lot of these ideas come from between myself, HKV, and DLX. We're constantly looking at some of the social media pages and see a lot of the questions hams are asking, especially new hams. And that's where I've always kind of tried to direct my channel to, is new hams and hams on a budget. And we're seeing lots of questions here lately about proper ways to mount antennas. So that's what we're going to talk about today. First and foremost, before I get into any method of how to put an antenna up, I want to make this perfectly clear. When I tell you how I put an antenna up is how I do it. I'm not telling you that it has to be done that way or for you to do it that way. Strictly the way I do it. Now, again, safety is your first and foremost thought in putting an antenna up. And I'm going to relay an incident to you here in just a second. You've got all kinds of ways to get hurt. If nothing else, from pinching your hands. Hey, ham radio cat. Come up here, boo-boo. Come on. Nothing from pinching your hands to dropping tools and hitting your partner on the ground to falling. And above board this, and this is the number one, power lines. Whatever you do, whatever antenna you erect, you make triple sure you're going to got enough clearance not to come in contact with the primary power line or even the secondary leg feeding your house. But for Pete's sake, do not come in contact with that 7,200 volt primary. And I'm going to relay an incident that happened. Back in the 70s, I actually met this guy years later because I worked with his wife when I worked for a Walmart store back in the late 70s. This happened in the early 70s. Not going to talk about what happened leading up to the accident or any safety aspects the guy should have had in place. I wasn't there. All I'm going to tell you is this, when you live in the country and you have a tendency to do things certain ways, and all I'm going to tell you is the results of what happens. Anyway, there's Ham Radio Cat. Aaron, there he is, buddy. I'm my number one fan, Aaron. He likes to see your Ham Radio Cat pop up here. All right, this guy was standing on a butane tank taking a television antenna down that was evidently on some type of push-up pole. I do not know what happened, how he lost control of it, or anything, but in the process of taking it down, him standing on a butane tank, he lost control of the antenna and the pole, and it came in contact with a 7,200-volt primary power line. Burnt both his arms off, I think at the shoulder, and burnt both his legs off at the knees. Quadruple amputee instantly. Said it left his footprints burnt into the butane tank. Hey, buddy, watch out now. So, realize that when you're putting an antenna up. I have to worry about that on my house because I wasn't thinking when I put my house out here. I'd kind of gotten out of radio a little bit, and I didn't really make it real radio friendly putting antennas up. So I have to really watch myself putting antennas up. But that is an extreme example of what can happen. And all it takes is that pole to fall and hit that primary power line. And you've got a major, major problem. Okay. I know that guy probably regrets how he did it, but he lived a pretty good life. I think after that, he had him 4 prosthetic limbs. And he actually lived over it and went on with his life. So think about that. Now think about this when you're putting antennas up, because we're mainly going to talk about HF antennas. And the lower you go in frequency, the bigger the antenna you've got is going to be put up. You start with a 10-meter antenna, you're looking at the driven element on a three-element Yagi, 16-something feet. And then your reflector is going to be slightly larger, longer. And then you've got probably a 10-foot boom, depending on who makes the antenna. I'm just spitballing sizes out here. And as you go lower in frequency, those antennas get bigger. In fact, I saw, some of y'all may have seen, I saw a picture today on one of the ham radio sites, somebody somewhere figured out a way to make an 80-meter three-element Yagi, and they were using a helicopter to set it. So that's when you've got a lot of deep pockets to do that. But safety. If somebody gives you a tower, a lot of ham radio operators get towers, give to them, just come take it down. First thing you better do, you better look at the base of that tower and see if it's split, where water has gotten in it over the years and built up and froze and split the tower legs. If it has, you better be real careful about whether you climb that or not, because it's probably not safe to climb. I've never climbed one. My knees are shot too bad. I'm not going to climb a tower. But I know a lot of people who do. And I know people who's gotten hurt climbing towers. Be aware of a tower before you get onto it. Okay? Thing you need is somebody there helping you. If you're going to climb a tower, you're going to need a tower climbing belt, hard hat protection, gloves, and a gin pole at the minimum, and at least one person on the ground sending stuff up to you. So you got to make plenty of plans in place to get that ahead of time. So let's look at a couple of ideas here now that HKV and DLX now come up with. You know, we're talking about Ron Towers. That's the ultimate goal for ham radio operators, put a Ron Tower up. I run my stuff on Ron push-up poles. You know, you've got, Ron makes excellent stuff. And if you buy one of their push-up poles, it's already got the rings on it to guy with. You got several different ways of mounting them. Come on, Cat. I don't want you chewing on. Get off there. Come on. Roof mounts. Eave mounts, where the end of the pole clamps to it. You've got three-legged roof mounts you could put a mast on. They actually got a smaller mount I think you could buy for a vertical antenna that just like a pipe coming out of the top of your roof, you nail to your roof and set that antenna in that. Different ways of mounting stuff. If you're going to use guy wire, I highly recommend Dacron rope. I'm using a 3/8 Dacron rope for my guys, and I've used it for years and I've had real good luck with it. It's got good UV resistance. A lot of people say use GI paracord. I've heard of people doing it. I don't think it has the same UV resistance as that Dacron rope does, and I've had real good luck with it. If you're going to mount a wire antenna on a push-up pole or a tower, there's cheap ways you can buy special brackets for this, or you can go to Lowe's and get a standard 12-inch shelf bracket for a few bucks, a couple of U-bolts. You bolt it to the side of it to hang your antenna out on it, so it gets it away from the mast to help less interacting with the antenna. In fact, on my G5RV I had up, I had a shelf bracket at the top. Then I put a 3-foot section of PVC pipe with a U of PVC connectors I made, clamped it to the pole to put the feed line in, the twin lead coming down in, to keep it 3 foot off the push-up poles that would interact. Had real good luck with it. Real cheap way of doing stuff like that. All right, let's see. Shelf brackets. Anything you use a standoff. Now, coax cable, you can wire tie it straight to the pole coming down or the tower legs. And they make special brackets to buy. And if your pockets are deep enough, that'll work. You know, main thing is get you a plan in place before you put this tower up. A lot of people will try, and this is a good idea. I've had trouble with rope tangling up on me. I've always said if I fell out of an airplane, I didn't want a parachute. I just have a 100-foot extension cord. It's going to hang something before I hit the ground. But if you put a push-up pole up, and you may change your dipole some, put your little pulley on it and some rope, and you just let it down and pull it up and have to take the pole down. It does help If you'll stretch that dipole out on the ground first and let it kind of set out there a little bit, get the kinks out of it before you pull it up so it don't twist. And if you're putting up a 160 dipole, I promise you that could be a problem. I had trouble with that putting mine up. Another thing to think about, and we don't have this anymore around here like we used to, but is a TVI, television interference. Most people are on antennas now, I mean on satellites and things like that now, or cable feeds. But if you do have somebody still using an antenna, you may have to put a high pass or a low pass filter in your feed line to help get so you don't eat the TV up. And I've seen people mount TV antennas on the tower with their ham antenna and they had problems. So something to think about there. Main thing when you put an antenna up is get a good plan out before you ever start this. Think about safety. Like we said earlier, number one is power lines. Dang sure don't want to come in contact with a power line because it's not going to end well and make for a really, really bad day. Number two, if you're climbing a tower, make sure it's climbable. And I've talked to people, actually lawyers has represented people that sued tower manufacturers where they climb a tower and it fell over. Now, who say it was put up right to begin with, I don't know. But before you climb one, especially an old one, you better inspect it to make sure you can climb it safely, try to take it apart and bring it back down. A lot of times they've been up a long time, they're so jammed together, they're hard to get apart. I've heard of people taking little bottle jacks up there with a board and trying to jack them apart. Again, got to be careful, got to be safe. Remember, if you drop something up there, your buddy on the ground better be ready for it. That's a good idea to have hard hats on both people. Now, again, you're only limited by the types of antennas you want to put up and your budget. So, I've always done things on a budget. HKV told me when I got into this hobby, it's always good practice not to put up more expensive antennas. Then you can get blowed. Then you can afford to have blowed down. And I kind of agree with that. I've worked the world on a wire. I've got a 17-meter wire homemade dipole up right now that I worked South Africa on here about a month ago. In fact, I got a card on the wall from it. You can make, if you look at some of my earlier videos, I showed how to make what I call a field expedient dipole. You don't have to have a bowline for it. You just got some pieces of plexiglass, plastic laying around, place to split it. You can make a dipole real simple, real inexpensive. That'll work as long as you use the right formulas and cut it correctly and check it before you put it up. And a lot of these new radios have tuners built into them, so it doesn't make it quite as critical, but it will perform better if it is cut for the frequency you're going to be using it on. Okay, I may have rambled a little bit in that, but main thing, safety. Get your plan in place. Work your budget. There's nothing wrong with using push-up poles. Probably going to have to guy them. I've got a two-element 10-meter beam up 50 foot with a rotor on it right now. And if you're going to use push-up poles, you can still buy what's called a light duty, which is a television rotor. I know Wayne Trading Company in Paris has them, a little over $100, brand new. I'm still using rotors that I picked up at swap meets years ago. I went down to my last one now. I'm using an old Alliance rotor. So sooner or later, I may have to buy a new rotor. If you're going to set up a tower, of course, you've got the opportunity where to put a tower plate. If you can afford a more expensive rotor, put them in there. But HKV can tell you can use a Channel Master rotor in a tower. And he put a monster beam on it, and it worked. Of course, ever the old ham radio operators that saw it, heads blew up every time they seen it, but he put it on there and he used it for a long time just like that, and it would work. So, you're only limited by your budget, your imagination, and what bands you're wanting to operate on. Oh, one other thing. I kind of didn't really get into verticals. Ground-mounted vertical antennas work great. They really do, especially for DX. I'm not sure how well it would work for ground wave communications. In fact, HKV and I are going to do some experimenting on that. He's got a 5BTV Hustler up, and I've got one in my shop that I need to put back up because I don't have anything up on 20 and 40 right now. But remember this, if you're going to use a, if you plan on doing some ground wave communicating like we do here and DXing, you're going to have to put the same polarization antennas up that everybody's going to be talking ground wave on, because just switching from vertical to horizontal, changing the polarization, you lose, there's 30 dB of loss. Doesn't affect DX contacts, but it does affect your ground wave communicating. So that's something to think about. Hope I didn't get that too confusing to everybody. Like I always say, my call sign's KB5MIQ. Got my email posted on my QRZ page. Drop me an email. If you got any questions, love to hear from you. Do me a favor, put your call sign in the subject matter so it'll catch my attention quicker, because I get a lot of emails that are from contests and things like that. Leave us a comment. Appreciate everybody who subscribed to the channel. If you know any hams that are interested in this stuff, tell them about my channel and get them subscribed to it. We're going to keep trying to make these videos as long as people like them. We like this hobby. We're going to try to keep supporting it. Hope everybody has a great weekend. This is KB5MIQ Big Boy 73.